What's going on, gamers? Today we're going to be going over thermal foundation, how to install it onto your Apex Minecraft server, and even how to play. Before we get into this tutorial, don't forget to give this video a like, subscribe, and click the notification bell so you can stay up to date on every tutorial we upload, just like this one. Creating redstone machines on your Minecraft world allows for many unique creations, but there aren't too many available options. Thermal Foundation, a forge mod, grants you more power to be creative in-game, as it adds new energy sources and gadgets. Today we're going to show you how to not only install Thermal Foundations, but we're going to show you some of the coolest parts of this mod. You need to have forge for this to work, but we have a tutorial on how to install Forge, so if you don't know how to do that, click on the link in the description so you can learn how to install Forge on your client version of Minecraft. But we're just going to show you how to install Thermal Foundation and COFH Core first. For installing on your client, go ahead and jump onto the Thermal Foundation CurseForge webpage and the COFH Core page. These both, of course, are going to be linked in the description of this video. Then on either page or both pages, go ahead and click on files. Then find the, or click on view all to find the ability to sort by versions. And once you found the version that you want, for this example, we're gonna use 1.18.2. So on Thermal Foundation, we found a version for this. And on COFH Core, we found a version for 1.18.2 as well. Now, click on download on both pages. Once they are both downloaded, click and drag them to a folder that is made for this purpose or something easy to find like your desktop. Now that you've downloaded these mods, we are ready to install them onto your server. Installing on the server is super easy. Make sure that you have both files on hand for this installation. So whether you put them on your desktop or a different folder just for this purpose, just open that folder up. And once you have that folder or just know where it is, go ahead and hop into your Apex server panel and click on stop so that you can click on FTP file access to proceed. Now go ahead and log in with your information. And once you're logged in, find the mods folder and click into it. Now go ahead and click on upload in the top left. This is going to take you to a page where you can now actually click on the folder finally and click on the Thermal Foundation jar and the COFH Core jar. Click on these both or drag them one at a time to the right-hand side of the webpage. Then wait until you see 100% for both mods and it should say uploaded 2 out of 2 mods. Afterward, you can click on the name of your server at the top of the page so you can restart the server, and once your server is online, it should load the mods. Getting started feels complicated, but once you know what to do, it feels natural. It really does. When you first load into the world with your mods enabled, it'll feel like normal Minecraft, except that if you enter creative mode, then the modded items are going to be displayed. And they have tons of crafting recipes for you to use in survival. Although the version you selected controls what items and crafting is available, in that case, you could just install the Just Enough Items mod to easily find your recipes. Some of the tools you're going to make at first are super useful. They can provide an improved game experience. For instance, these items can assist with mining or collecting loot with their unique functionalities. We're not going to go over a ton of tools, but we're going to show you some of our favorite ones, or just our favorite one, which is the remote detonator. When you're mining for vanilla or modded ores, TNT could be used to clear pathways and create more areas for getting resources. However, explosions hurt players and you wouldn't want to lose any gear because then that defeats the purpose of mining. This remote detonator solves the problem by protecting you when igniting TNT, as it allows you to explode it from a distance. In order to do this, you need to right-click the block, press V, and then right-click again. It's an easy, the easiest way to detonate explosions without worrying about dying in-game. Then, this mod introduces the Tinkerer's Workbench. It's the main aspect to Thermal Foundation and its energy and machinery uses. There's a fuel in-game that ranges from crude oil to redstone flux, which is required to create machines and powered items. The Tinkerer's Workbench is how you and other players manage these sources, or energy sources. Unfortunately, there isn't much to do with the base mod since the add-ons are what truly allows for creativity. Some of the mobs introduced by this mod are three hostile mobs, which are the Blizz, the Blitz, and the Bazals. These entities are similar to Blazes, but with unique features. The Blizz mob spawns in cold biomes. The Blitz spawns in deserts and savannas, and the Bazals spawn in mountains or hill biomes. All three mobs are rarer than any other hostile entity and can be in groups of 1 to 4. They're super difficult to kill, so be careful when exploring the mentioned biomes. And now we're going to go over some configuration. Thermal Foundation's configuration can be found in the thermal-server.toml file from your world's server config directory. You can get here by clicking on FTP file access and logging in, and either finding it in the config folder or looking for the thermal-server.toml file. It contains a variety of settings to edit, such as blocks, retaining energy, or specific item uses. There shouldn't be any need to edit these options, but it's available to you. Although, if you install thermal add-ons, then it would be beneficial to review the config file. Using Thermal Foundation's materials to craft specialized machines or items gives you and other players the opportunity to be creative. There's tons of different resources available in the world, so exploring can be pretty fun. Once all the materials you need are gathered, you can craft any tools to help with collecting more loot. It also assists with locating or creating new energy sources for your custom machinery. If you decide to install thermal add-ons, there's going to be tons of features added in the world for even more creativity. Well, folks, that's all we got for you today, and as always, we hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.